What's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever, and we are back with more Spear of Destiny Floor 16. This is, without a doubt in my mind, the hardest floor in Spear of Destiny, and this is pretty much the reason why, what you're about to see here. Let's make sure this door is wide open. Run out, and run back in, quickly. Now, I'm going to use my machine gun when dealing with this part. We have pretty much what this floor is composed of is just huge numbers of enemies. Like, I'm talking huge. Like, if you thought the last floor was tough, this floor puts that floor to shame. Like, I'm telling you what, if there's anything that this floor is made up of, it's enemies. So, we've just gotten rid of our first big group of guys. We need the silver key to get through there. Now, there's a secret... Oh, jeez. There's a secret on that wall. Now, behind the pillars here, we have another big number of enemies. And if you don't use the machine gun, there's a good chance that you could run out of ammo fast. So that's what you don't want to happen. So in here, there's treasures and some ammo. We'll leave that ammo. Gosh, we need more ammo. Like, ammo and... particularly ammo is probably the most important thing you want to conserve in this floor. So, we will not go over there yet. I don't even want to think about that part. So, let's go to get started. Or, well, yeah, to continue on. We'll go in here. Holy crap, we just woke up all the guys. Yeah, this is one of the more... this is probably one of the few times where I'll actually take an extremely conservative approach when it comes to, you know, handling big armies of Nazis like this, is standing up against the wall and just waiting for them to come out. And if you find, like, you can stand right here, but if you find that you're being shot from behind, then you can just, oh, man, somebody shot me good. Probably a mutant. Yeah, I know. Oh, no, it was that officer, but, anyway. Just stand where the guys won't be able to hit you. So, like, stand up against this corner wall here. So, oh, jeez, mutants. Alright, anybody? Oh, gosh, Schustoffel, you two die. Okay. Let's get this food and push this wall. This is our second secret. And when we push it, we're gonna go in. Oh, well, I almost grabbed that on accident. Yeah, we're gonna save that. That's actually probably one of, again, that's actually probably one of the few times we'll ever save an extra life. But let's just take a quick look around. Okay, no one is alive through here. And we have an even tougher area. This hallway is completely made up of mutants just everywhere. Like, mutants around every corner. Along with crosses. So there's a secret, oh, whoops, next to the wall with the vent. Oh, gosh. Get rid of you guys. Okay, yeah, there's nothing down there in that alcove back there. So in here, we have health and ammo. We're gonna save some of it. And we have another mutant here. And I think, did he just see me? Oh, yeah, we're gonna carefully pick off these mutants. Because we don't want them to open those doors. Holy crap. If they open those doors, we're scrawed. Alright, now, here's where the fun comes into this floor. You thought all that was tough? Watch this. Immediately run back here because you don't... I mean, yeah, you gotta move. You gotta move. Because you don't want them to gang up on you. And just remember, you have a nice little stash of ammo behind you. 3 crates, that's a good 75 bullets. So if you run low on bullets, just back up. In fact, I gotta grab all 3 of them. This is the area that will most likely chip your health down low. Especially if you stand out in the open like a fool like I am. Okay. Yeah, I mean, look at that. Like, you think that's enough... like, you think that's enough carnage right there? I mean, look at that. There's human blood and frickin' mutant blood on the wall. You don't see that every day. But anyway, let's just go in here to where they were. We have another secret there on the eagle here. And when we go in here, we got a nice little storeroom of sorts. We got treasure, health, ammo, or... well, health is pretty much mostly made up of food. Right here, let's grab the silver key. And we'll just make our way down this hallway here. Now, when you get to this door, be extremely careful. Go out, just blast, and then go back in. Yeah, here's where I'm actually going to use the break out the chain gun. Big boy. Now, if you didn't kill the guys on the inside of the pillars before, this is where they'll most likely show up. I need more ammo. And I need more health. Well, let's go and get the food here. Okay, I need to get more ammo before we progress. I just have to. Did I get them all? I hope I got them all. And there's probably more ammo just from those guys alone than in the entire floor. I don't know. Whatever. Of course I took all the ammo out of there. Oh, good. Gimme. Oh, hey. Where are you? Oh, yeah, you die. Not gonna get me today. Alright, yeah. Mostly I'm just picking off all the guys, like all the stragglers. So let's open up the silver door. And we have to push this wall. This secret is actually required to finish the floor. So yes, collect all the treasures you see. And look at that, back up to full bullets again. Now, okay, there's one guy in there that's just running around. Rummaging around in there. Alright, I need him to come out. It'll just be so much easier. Crap, come here. Alright, he's dead. And I'll wait for that door to close. Okay, now, let's just make our way down here, get the last of the treasures. Now, here comes quite an epic confrontation. What lies inside this room, you may ask? Well, it is Dr. Shabs's most prized creation, the Uber Mutant. And he is quite formidable. And as a matter of fact, he runs pretty fast. And he has a chain gun mounted on his chest. And besides that, he has like four cleavers in his hands. Yeah, I know, his four arms. Which, you know, makes him look real threatening. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly run and grab this extra life. I told you it was going to be good for something. And now we need to quickly head back. What I'm hoping is that he did not come outside. If he came outside... Oh, God, he's right there. Oh, jeez, he's right there. All right, I'm going to have to pull him back this way. That's the only way I'm going to be able to do this. So, yeah, he'll come back this way. Actually, let me get some food out of here. I wasn't expecting to take that much damage from him. But, you know, what are you going to do, right? So let's just get the rest of the food in here because, I mean, we're pretty much never coming back here. Let's see where he is. Alright, well, at least he's away from the entrance to where I need to go. It'd be good if we could get him... Yeah, there he is. I tell you what, he is scary. Like, the first time I saw him, I was freaked out. Like, how fast I saw him run and everything, he's creepy. He just goes right. Wow, he just went right down like that. I guess I whittled his health down right as I left. But anyway, he'll drop a gold key, and there's his corpse. Yeah, he makes like some really weird roaring sound, as you just heard. But yeah, when you go into his room, there's freaking nothing in here. It's just two crates of ammo. That's that. It's like two boxes of bullets. That's it. So when we come into this room, this is the last of this floor. We have more mutants, and we have more mutants, two more mutants in the elevator. And our final secret, whoops, right there. Alright, so let's just go in here, get the crosses, get the crayons, and that's it, guys. That is floor 16, and the Uber Mutant has been defeated. Let's go. Whew, my gosh. This floor is not as big as the last one, but damn, it is so dense, so thickly populated that... Does that even make sense? I don't know. It makes sense now. I'm officially making that so that it makes sense. It is so dense with enemies. It's so thickly populated. It's just insane. Right when you start this floor, you don't get a break. Like, it's just, it's crazy. You have so many, like, you have a huge pack of guys coming at you from the left and to the right, on top of the enemies that are shooting at you from behind the pillars next to the Uber Mutant's room. So, pretty much the hardest part, there's not a single easy part with this floor. It's all hard. The Uber Mutant himself, he's actually pretty difficult, I will say. He's actually quite a step up in difficulty since Barnacle Wilhelm. And although he doesn't have a rocket launcher, I mean, he's got that chest-mounted chain gun, which that's enough to just scare you and intimidate you. So, and with how fast he moves, too, I mean, that's just crazy. I mean, think about it. Like, you've got this thing just coming at you with a chain gun on its chest, four cleaver knives in its hands, and, like, it's got four arms to begin with. Which, like I said, it is Dr. Shabs's best, considered to be the Dr. Shabs' best creation. And I gotta say, it's one hell of a boss. I gotta say that. It puts up a pretty good fight. Luckily, I mean, it does go down okay. A little easily. I don't know. It doesn't go down as easily as Tron's, or Barnacle for that matter, but once you beat him, well, yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the last of the castle's floors. So the next floor will actually be in the castle's ramparts. And, yeah, pretty soon we'll be at the very tip-top, where we will get the spear. But, we'll get to that later. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I will catch you later in Floor 17.